My name is Evin Yucel. I'm a clinical instructor at Harvard Medical School and an assistant physician in the heart valve program of the Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts. In today's talk, we're going to talk about the choice between surgical aortic valve replacement versus transcatheter aortic valve replacement within the landscape of 2020 ACC/AHA Valvular Heart Disease Guidelines. Key takeaways of this talk are reviewing the indications for surgical aortic valve replacement versus transcatheter aortic valve replacement, reviewing the outcomes of transcatheter aortic valve replacement in patients with bicuspid aortic valve stenosis, and reviewing antithrombotic therapy after aortic valve replacement. With the remarkable advances in transcatheter treatment of aortic stenosis, we now have shown that TAVR is a safe and effective procedure in all adults, regardless of their estimated surgical risk. In this meta-analysis of all TAVR trials, the mortality rate for transfemoral transcatheter aortic valve replacement is lower than that of the surgical aortic valve replacement, with a hazard ratio of 0.88. TAVI is also associated with a lower risk of stroke, major bleeding, and atrial fibrillation, as well as shorter hospital length of stay, less pain, and more rapid return to normal activities. Compared to surgical aortic valve replacement, TAVR results in higher rates of vascular complications, paravalvular regurgitation, and permanent pacemaker implantation, along with valve reintervention. The only caveat is that we have accumulated data for about 50 years for surgical aortic valve replacement durability, whereas the longest durability data for TAVR valves go up to only 5 years. We need to keep in mind that the earlier trials comparing surgical aortic valve replacement and transcatheter aortic valve replacement included only older patients with a mean age of mid-80s. The more recent trials studying patients at low and intermediate risk had a mean age of mid-70s, with a very few number of patients less than 65 years of age. With this data in mind, the concern of lack of data on valve durability in younger patients, SAVR is recommended for adults younger than 65 years of age. Both SAVR and TAVR are effective approaches to AVR in adults between 65 and 80 years of age. For symptomatic patients with severe aortic stenosis who are older than 80 years of age, or for younger patients with a life expectancy less than 10 years and no anatomical contraindications to transfemoral TAVI is recommended in preference to surgical aortic valve replacement. SAVR is recommended for patients who do not have suitable anatomy for transfemoral transcatheter aortic valve replacement. For those who have an expected survival of less than 12 months, or for whom who are expected to have minimal improvement in quality of life, palliative care is recommended after shared decision making. The early pivotal TAVR trials excluded patients with bicuspid aortic valve. Initial studies showing early generation valves suggested a higher rate of paravalvular leak in the bicuspid population, but data from the STS-ACC transcatheter valve registry suggests that with the use of newer generation prosthetic valves, the rate of paravalvular leak is no different among the groups. This registry also showed no significant difference in mortality rate at 30 days and 1 year between bicuspid patients and tricuspid valve groups. However, the stroke rate at 30 days was higher in the bicuspid group. It's also important to note that patients with bicuspid aortic valve are often much younger, and long-term outcomes beyond 5 years is unclear after transcatheter aortic valve replacement. Low-dose aspirin is recommended after transcatheter or surgical aortic valve replacement. And if there is no bleeding risk, a vitamin K antagonist can be used for 3 to 6 months after surgical AVR. If there is no bleeding risk, dual antiplatelet therapy for 3 to 6 months post-transcatheter aortic valve replacement, or a vitamin K antagonist for 3 months can be considered, and this carries a class 2B indication in the current guidelines. Given the concern about the risk of bioprosthetic valve thrombosis post-TAVR, the role of anticoagulation was studied within the GALILEO trial. Patients who did not have any other indication for anticoagulation were randomized to low-dose rivaroxaban plus low-dose aspirin or clopidogrel 75 milligrams plus low-dose aspirin. The primary efficacy outcome was the composite of death and thromboembolic events. The primary safety outcome was major or disabling or life-threatening bleeding. The trial, interestingly, was stopped early at a median follow-up of 17 months because of safety concerns. In the rivaroxaban group, there were higher rates of death or first thromboembolic event and all-cause mortality compared with the antiplatelet-only group. Major bleeding was more frequent in the rivaroxaban group, but the rates of life-threatening or disabling bleeding were actually similar in these two groups. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video educational.